World Devourer.
The dream OD game.
I like that OD.
It's Bales Marana and Artesian Timbersaw.
We've got a double. Yeah, both teams actually smoked up and went for the opposing bounty rune. So we've some dodging action, it looks like, happening.
Yeah, EG having the chance of getting this connection, in fact, onto the Abaddon. They are going to spot each other out, and we'll see if they try and make a go. KP trying to man up between these three. Quite hard to bring down the Abaddon. He will get caught up by the Torrent. And in fact, he's just got the one level in the Aphotic Shield. I don't know if it's going to be enough there already. EG chasing down KP, and that will be... No! Tries to salve up, not quite enough. Universe takes the first blood.
Don't believe he got the Stout Shield blocked there. He was hoping for it, of course, but...
And at the moment, Moogie pretty much free farm up on this top lane. Not a lot that EG can do to slow him down. He's nearly level 3. He's got the backup of his supports. It's a scary lane. Universe and Zai have to be very careful.
Invis tanking.
Especially with Kaka coming in, getting the two-man bro strike from Invis. Universe just looks, he's going for the TP out, but he's not going to quite make it. That'll be one. Zai will just get himself away. Mid lane, Samael and Crit at the same time, going in with the harassment. But as we're seeing, this top lane, tri lane, I mean, granted, the Sand King did have an invis, but there's definitely kill potential here for Newbee. Oh, hey, Universe! He just finds himself a freebie, KP, in the jungle. I don't know if he was trying to deny himself there. It was only to the small neutrals, but it didn't work out, and Universe was ready to go.
Just, he's got to still keep TPing down there, though, so he still has to be getting that experience. His job in this game, he has to be a bit farmed.
He had to be careful here. Came a little too close for the CS, and now there's the setup with the Astral Imprisonment coming in with the Burrow Strike. Faith there as well to join in the party. We'll get the value CS on the way down with the arrow, but that will be Samael taken out. Same time though, up top, they realize that Moogie, he's left alone, and evil geniuses, as soon as they see an opportunity on top, they try and go, but Moogie is just a little too big. Tangoes it up, walks away.
So we've actually got, it's 5 minutes, first catapult wave. KP actually pulls the lane bottom. So now Artesi's got a full wave and a catapult going under the tower.
KP has to be so careful.
He's got they're going to push this tower here.
He can easily dive this tower, especially with the help of Universe. KP, they're going to be in trouble again. The shield's taken down. They will sprout him up. Trying to get Artesi in position to get the burst damage through, but as it is,
right
Universe.
Right clicks are adding up.
Right clicks, he's just doing it here. KP, he's going to be going down again. The same time though in the mid lane, Newbee again with that tri lane play. Bringing in the two supports do get Samael. S-triple-C and Faith both looking for him. They will get the glimpse back, but oh!
The timber chain, all the way across.
And he goes for the TP out. Artesi, the 10k madman, gets away.
That
what
was sick.
A cute little play there from the boy. Top lane, Boogie as well. He says I could TP out, but no! Zai's there! He
and the arrow.
Six. The arrow's in. EG, take down Moogie.
They have detection, says Crit.
Destroy the barracks, then get back. let's not get ahead of ourselves, Samael here. There's still tier ones to take down.
That's not a great place either. There's
go for
power, but now with Artesi coming in and KP overextending a bit.
With him coming out this far, they
trouble.
Definitely should have potential to bring him down twice. Here's the first setup from Crit. Brings him back. It's the Torrent. Borrow timeout straight away. KP, he has got backup on the way. Faith TP's in. Aphotic Shield's out again. KP should be fine. Now it's Evil Geniuses that have to be careful. Faith, with the glimpse back onto Crit. S-triple-C in the neighborhood as well, trying to chase this down. Can he quite close the gap for the Astral? There's going to be the Torrent to create the space, and in fact, EG jump back in. The Starstorm for Samael. They take down KP, and they may even get more out of this as well. They walk out the Static Storm, and Evil Geniuses just turn around.
They had everything going for them there. Newbee in a place where it was a awkward place, like awkward location to fight. Artesi able to delay it long enough for the backup to arrive. Universe with the Wrath of Nature. More than enough damage coming through. Does Newbee have Blink on Sand King yet? They are 400 short, so defending this tier 1 is going to be very difficult.
Don't even get the deny there as EG take the tower, looking for the Torrent, but in fact, Sleep will mean that the Torrent doesn't connect. Nonetheless, they want to go in for more. Here comes the boat straight away. S-triple-C will get the dodge off with the
Astral. Oh, the Static Storm!
And now the turnaround, 3 a trap. Massive ult from Moogie. Evil Geniuses, they have to get out somehow. Zai trying to run under the cover of the Moonlight Shadow from Samael, but it's not enough. Zai is down. They're going to lose both of them. Zai and Samael falling as Newbee come in perfectly with that turnaround. That great angle.
We now do see the song coming out. They are on the prowl for some newbie heroes.
See if they can get Moogie. Moogie, he is going to head up to the high ground very dangerously close to them. Samael has the DD as well. There's the X mark setup. Can he get himself out of this one? Well, with Universe and the silence there, there's no way he gets out. Tries to shove himself away, but the damage is too much. EG will claim the kill.
S-triple-C is walking right up on Crit right now.
He's trying to find some Avengers. He gets it, jukes out the shard. And the damage coming in brings some incredibly low. Zai has to song. to make sure there's no chance of a sanities or so turning around. They try and go for the arrow timing, but it's all evil geniuses. They mess up Die. That mech play does keep him alive, but they turn for the bigger kill. Arteezy's turned up into a bit of a static storm.
They do not want to fight into this OD right now. 72 in stolen at this point. This is scary.
And still working towards that.
And sometimes we see versus those BKBs, what's good is those instant disables, which EG does not have in this type of game. They don't have a Blink Echo Slam. They don't have a Blink Sanctioned Sun.
With this Moonlight though, they will have eyes on Takaka. He's actually just going to duke it out.
They can't quite
catch him. Now he jumps forward, looking to block them off, and that's going to allow his Triple Z to come in. They will Song, but that's going to mess up the boat combo.
They got Sumail Glimpse back already.
And that, they've got the kill with that one. That's the big one. Sumail down for 55, and EG, I mean, it feels like they're getting sort of the jitters here on this main stage. They're making all these plays, but they're not very coherent. And Newbee, they're keeping it cool. The items and the power that Newbee have amassed, they can start thinking about trying to push down tier 2s and maybe even getting up to the high ground.
And the rush isn't even that slow because, you know, the Curse of Avernus, the Abaddon's already starting to scale so heavily that it actually accelerates it that much for.
Looks like it's going to be the Aghanim's. He picks up the point booster. That's going to be the next point of call, and I mean, that obviously brilliant as well. If they do want to try and do something about ending the game soon, it's going to be massive. Up top, they will have the start of Evil Geniuses going for the play, and they'll pull it down.
Oh, they actually cursed him down before.
Very nicely done.
He's got the Silver Edge,
hasn't he, yeah. Universe?
Silver Edge Orchid, unable to use that ultimate.
Nothing
from Baden.
He can do.
Newbee with that Aegis.
It's all about that.
Making the play now toward mid, smoked up on the two supports behind the OD. They're showing the Venomancer top too, so EG might not be expecting this one.
I mean, Sumail, we just talked about him having a tough game. It's about to get even rougher as they trap him in the static. So Newbee again with these big, big pickoffs. And at this pace, I don't know if Sumail's even going to get the chance to catch back into this game. As, you know, amongst it all, they're still top of the second on the net worth.
They're trying to make a play.
So much across the map.
When that Aegis expires, they're trying to make a play here. But the BKB is back online for SCCC.
I mean, it's... How do they catch it? They have to get
Torrent
the
arrow.
This is the combo. Torrent there, into the arrow, perfectly done. The Orc in the boat. Very, very clean execution from EG.
That's the only way they can do it is if he can't get the BKB off with the full.
I mean, and now that is an OD down for a minute. SCCC does not have buyback.
Yep.
This top lane, looking to be in trouble as EG are coming forward. Kaka tries with the epicenter, but he barely catches anyone. He gives a bit of a tickle to Arteezy, but EG stick around. The silence is down to KP. He's forced back. Moogie will
storm on two.
The storm
on three.
Has trapped three of them here. EG may have overstayed their welcome with the burst strike as well. Newbee still fight back hard without their OD. They may even get more as there's the glimpse back onto Crit. Newbee say this is very much still a game we have a hold on as they bring four of EG down. And EG, quite like myself, maybe getting a little too excited off the back of taking down the OD.
I was just sitting there. It's the Nature's Prophet and the Murano for that evasion, but it's just annoying that how farmed this Abaddon can be already. Level 22, getting closer and closer to our 25 universe.
We'll see. Jumping in, has the setup, sentry down, so I will come in with the save. And straight with
the glimpse!
He was there outside of the sleep radius, ready to set up with the glimpse back, and universe is gone. I mean, Newbee, nothing goes past these guys. They will catch you.
There's a way toward an Aghanim's as well. That's going to be a really nice little luxury piece that he can pick up. And the siege comes out now.
Yeah, now this is Newbee's turn to go. This is how you break a high ground. The boat will come through. It's going to be juked out, whether it be Yules or Astral Imprisonments, to keep Newbee safe. Jump forward. SCCC just goes in. They jump forward with a bonus strike. Crit will be kept alive by Zai. Only Jeffs. The pipe's out as well. Buyback from Universe as they do their best to hold here, EG. But already the tier 3 falling low. They will force the BKB out on SCCC. Newbee now looking to disengage. EG chasing down with the Moonlight. Can they actually get a catch onto anyone? At the same time, indeed, top lane. The rack came through. Universe did take the top melee racks. So EG, with this hold, with this split, they are paying very heavily with lives. Both Sumail and Crit go down. They got the melee racks trade, but was it worth it? Because now Newbee are back in. They know there's two down on EG. Faith will end up going down in the base as Arteezy continues to put on the pressure. But Evil Genius' base looking to be in the bigger shambles as Newbee will clean up the middle lane of racks. But it doesn't matter if you're splitting the racks, if you're losing the base, One tier 4 almost certainly going to fall, potentially 2. Now the buybacks have just come back on. Sumail can get back in, but already both tier 4s down. Newbee looking towards the base. There's the buyback. Can they hold? Arteezy with the Shiva's Guard trying to slow them down. The arrow connects onto the OD. Tora follows through as well. Here comes the bow, but SCCC jukes it just in time with the Astral Imprisonment. Newbee, they're focusing the base. They're looking for the game. Arteezy looks to cut down Moogie. Not quite enough damage. Moogie's still alive. BKB out by SCCC. Blinks in. Finishes off the game. Newbee take game one.
Wow. Super impressive way that they stalled the game out.
And it's going to be Bloodseeker. All right.
Yeah, Bloodseeker deals with Lycan. I think you have to deal with either one or the other because they don't have to spend, so Bloodseeker deals with Lycan.
As we saw that pressure, just SCCC using his dominance in this lane.
While he's low, though, Universe top is just getting chased out because of the third.
Yeah, look at this with the Blood Rite. That's going to connect. Universe, he's going to be gone. I mean, this top lane couldn't have gone any better for Moogie.
He might get a return kill with the Eidolons. It's going to be very close, but no, with the poor man's shield, the damage block is too high.
Look at the denies from SCCC. 21 denies in this mid lane.
Yeah. Shrine comes up. We'll use that right away.
Zai's got to be a bit careful. Nice. It's only level 2. There is a Haste Rune on SCCC. He has a Sonic Wave. I mean, if he wants to commit, Zai's certainly gone and well with the wraparound from Kaka. Coming in with the Boulder Smash, Zai, he'll try and play around with it here with the Burrow Strike. But SCCC just throws out the Sonic Wave, jumps in, cleans up one. I mean, he can look to play around with Sumail as well. They are going to have Kaka moving out of range. Arcane Rune bottled up by SCCC. So heads up to top, joins his teammates. Can look to try and get the tier 1 trade in return. And still, the potential for a kill is there. Crit in the neighborhood. Trying to see if they can get the glimpse. Now with the lead forward, they have the vision with the Thunderstrike. Kaka, I don't know if he can get himself out of this. He can certainly play with him with the Boulder Smash. He tries for the roll away, but there's the glimpse. Gets brought back into the clutches of Artur and Universe. And EG do claim the kill and should be able to finish off this tower as well. I've avoided the potential that Newbee's smoke had there, which was an incredible amount. Immediately, KP splits himself back up towards the top. Maskeeper's coming in mid. If they can get the catch here, which indeed Crit can, brings back Moogie. Now the whole team of EG ready
to go. Silence from Kaka.
Good smash back from Kaka to hold back the side of EG, but the Malefice was there onto Moogie, allowing them to chase him down.
They've got Black Hole. There's no blink yet for the Enigma to get into the fight.
Can they get it quick enough? They are mass TPing over, but it's falling so fast. They are. Walls have been sent in. EG know the state. Can Zai make the play in time? Roshan falling low. There's the jump onto Shaman on the sideline. It's falling down. They're dropping the ult. They take that one, but they get Roche. Newbee have the Aegis, but the Black Hole from the Universe comes in at the pip out for the pit. And EG, they take 3. SCCC may get out as well as Kaka. But EG, they're happy with that. They know that SCCC is there in the middle lane. They did spot him out as he cleared the wave. But they want to try and cut off this push that Newbee put together up top. KP on the front lines. Still under the cover of smoke. EG have the ward there. They've got perfect vision. There's the jump forward. Malefice first onto Fade. Not looking to commit the ult because they don't need the black hole for that one. That's the Shaman down. Arteezy will transform as they may look to take more. KP control for the moment by the kinetic field. Universe keeping it. There's the
three
jump again! Universe with the three-man black hole! It's absolutely perfect! They take down 3. They get the Aegis as well. Moogie will escape. There's CCC also potentially in trouble. Universe blinking forward, getting the vision. Zai comes in with the Burrow Strike. SCCC one more blink. Do they want to chase it? Universe did have Malefice again, but they will let SCCC be. But beautiful play there from Universe. They want to try and fight, so Universe still vulnerable, but we saw how much he did before without having to rely on the BKB.
Jump easy pick.
And they'll look to just go immediately onto Faith. Malefice, the Midnight Pulse down. They'll put the Reaper's Scythe, make sure that Shaman's down for 50 seconds.
They can get an invasion play here too. Arteezy is already positioned top for the push, so easy tier 2 can be claimed, but deep ward though from Newbee, so they see everything for this engagement if they want to take it. But a trade is the choice coming up.
And in fact, Universe, he says, I can smell someone in these trees, clears out the tree line with the Midnight Pulse. An absolute jackpot. He hits it, finds nice Kaka. Stuff. No chance of contesting it at this state with the items and DD just being an extra bit of a bonus there for Arteezy. We grab the Aegis, cheese goes the way of Sumail. This SCCC is still down bottom.
They might lose Kaka here. If he gets spotted out by Zai, it's a possibility.
I see they do scan. They do the scan. Connects onto a triple C, and yeah, with a midnight pulse, oh, they're going to catch him. There we go, straight away with the black hole. No messing around. Polar Smash will connect, but it's too late. The Queen of Pain's down, and Kaka with that play may have just paid with his own life. Will Yules up the SK to try and get around it, but you can't Yules underneath the tornado. He's stuck in the kinetic field. EG, they're going to get both of them out of this push. They even bring in some ale to add a bit of extra pain there to the death of the Earth Spirit. Down for 70 seconds.
That map awareness.
These scans, you know, they could read it. They know that someone's hiding there.
And here we go. Smoke. It's 20 seconds till it's up. They draw the line. They see the Bloodseeker bottom now, too, so they know that he's not going to be in the fight right away.
This should be a successful move from EG. Newbee, are they ready for this? Kaka on the front of it all. He's going to be the one to tank it. Jump forward straight away. They're looking for more. EG, they're not contented with just one. They get the vision, drag back KP, held in the Midnight Pulse, but the Necro unit's out as well. EG just ripping through this Bristleback, and KP's gone as well. Evil geniuses.
Oh, boy. It's looking impossible for Newbee to do anything. This is, they don't even have to use Black Hole. It's the BKB that we were talking about. It's just too much. They can't deal with it. They have no way to counter it. But now they're trying to bait SCCC mid. Maybe this could be the play that works for them.
BKB comes out, and now the potential turnaround. Universe will commit the Black Hole, but he didn't pop the BKB.
BKB?
He gets silenced. Now the turnaround. They will take down Sumail. Can they get anything more? RTZ pops the BKB, starts to chase towards Kaka. They found Faith. Kaka's going to be able to roll away safely. It's a one for one at the moment. Newbee with the edges. They've taken down Sumail. Now Zai jumps in looking for Moogie. Moogie will get taken down. Now it's EG getting the lead. SCCC trying to finish off crit. Earn a Shadow's heal. Not enough to keep the Disruptor alive. RTZ's lost the ult. Before SCCC jumping back in, Kaka's there looking for the setup. Yules up onto Zai. They've got the control. Boulder Smash connects onto both. SCCC trying to finish him off, but Zai up to the high ground. Do they have the vision? They don't have any sentries down at that point, so Zai will be able to continue to run. KP though chasing down RTZ. Four stacks. Can Universe save him? He can't. Nothing he can do to keep KP off RTZ. And a beautiful fight there. I mean, as you said, it was absolutely the bait there from Newbee. EG do still have the lead.
That's the
Newbee, they're into the pit.
The dream scenario.
They're going to get it.
They get that fight happening. Universe doesn't click the BKB, of course, but they get the win in the fight and the Varosh respawns right afterwards. So Aegis Chi is going in their favor. You don't want to play with your Black Hole into multiple lives. And this is where Newbee is going to try to take advantage of it. Because if the Black Hole does come off with the BKB, they don't have to cancel it now. They can wait for people to respawn and do that. Crit. Trying to walk up. He's gonna tank the game.
He's gonna get jumped on. Will get the Glimmer Cape off and jumps back. The Boulder Smash comes through. They're trying to turn around. The Universe coming in, but no! He gets it off, but it's only onto one. Will kill the Shadow Shaman. But overall, EG, they're falling apart. Samael's gone. Universe just has to TP out of there. RTZ trying to man up against SCCC, but he blinks away. Newbee just chasing down. Glimmer Cape is on him again. Crit will save him, but Crit pays with his life. And again, Newbee.
This is huge for Newbee now. They can actually go high ground.
Yeah,
there's no black
absolutely.
Hole now. The only threat is Epicenter.
No buybacks either on the two that are down. Will pop the Aegis there on the side. Zai trying to slow them down with the Burrow Strike. But I don't think Newbee will have any plans of backing up. They're going to stand their ground, pushing onto the tier threes here.
This could be
now. They get jump in with the Abyssal. The Boulder Smash comes through onto two. Newbee, they're doing it here. They found nearly RTZ as well. No, the cheese comes out. RTZ will survive. Buyback forced out though from Zai. Newbee still clean up the melee racks in the middle lane. And Newbee, they played this game very patiently. And ever since that bit of a blunder from EG in the middle lane,
they got Shadow Shaman 1-2.
This is
definitely
going to be a second set of racks for Newbee here. No holding back. They are not leaving this base. Universe, 17 seconds to the black hole. Can they keep it off this rack? They can't. The melee racks are gone. They make the jump in onto KP. Can they actually get this kill? The Midnight Pulse is down. They do have the Reaper side. They'll bring down the Bristle. But two melee racks gone. Newbee, they've done their work. They're going to be all smiles at the moment, and evil geniuses are going to feel incredibly shaken up. Very quickly there by EG.
The side lanes though, that's the issue. The catapults start hitting on the shrines in the mid lane, so shrine is almost actually brought down at about 150 life. And the bottom wave...
Oh, they've actually found him here! They jump in, they find him in the trees, they have the shackle onto Zai. RTZ pops the BKB, now make the leap onto paper. SCCC comes in the back lines. Universe will hold him in place with the BKB black hole. Have they got the damage to finish off? Yes, they have. Zai comes in with the AP. Hey, Evil Genius, they found two. Can they get KP as well? Sumail has to keep his distance. They've lost RTZ. RTZ does not have buyback. Moogie manning up with the BKB, looks towards Zai, will get the kill, gets the heal, keeps himself alive. KP moving in onto Sumail. Reaper side, not enough to bring down the Bristle. The mana.
Oh my god!
The tower hits. Is it enough? KP will finally go down. Universe does it there with the Midnight Pulse. EG have lost three, but at the same time bringing down three members of Newbee themselves.
But EG's base, it's getting destroyed by these creeps and catapults.
And contest this Roshan, and there should be a free Aegis and a cheese into the pockets of Newbee. They'll make a scan, EG starting to move a couple over, but it's not going to be anywhere.
The cheese is still on the ground. Oh, they actually pick it up. RTZ almost got
it. It looked like he was going to be able to deny it.
Looks like they're trying to take an unexpected fight at this tier 2 with the way Universe was positioned. But now they've shown all their faces. So now Zai actually also has a Lincoln Spear picked up. So now if Zai throws the Lincolns on Universe, they actually cannot.
Oh, they're opening up here. Black Hole will be committed onto KP. They're trying to burst down the Bristle on the sideline.
He gets the cheese off, though.
Gets the 2-man burst up, and indeed the cheese comes out. The Sonic Universe with a refresher. Black Hole is caught too. Has a corner triple C, but will bring down Moogie. But Evil Geniuses, they've lost two. Buyback immediately on both Sumail and Universe. They'll try and re-enter the fight. Sumail falling down low. Burst strike comes out from Zai. They will fight KP a second time. Silence is now onto the Queen of Pain. The Midnight Pulse bringing it. Triple C down low, he'll lose the Aegis, he's gone. Buyback from Crit, the Eidolons are out. Can they get back in on this? Mass buyback from Newbee, they want to finish this game off. As Triple C jumps forward, we'll have the Shadow Strike reflected back to him.
This is their time to end
they
it.
Know they know that, that
yeah, even Bristle buyback. Look, yeah, they know there's no black holes.
They
every
are going
single ulti.
Fully in Newbee. Can EG really hold? 60 seconds until the black hole's back. 60 seconds before Arteezy's back in the game.
This is a double catapult wave as well that's going to be coming in for the 50-minute mark.
Zai just doing everything he can to slow them down. Jumps in with a bonus try. The Midnight Pulse bringing Moogie down low, but the wards are there. Fate gets the shackles, but the force back keeps him alive. But turning around with the boulder pull does silence the Sand King. Fate goes scepters, drawing their attention towards the side. Zai with the sandstorm and the Malefice is enough to bring down Fate. They brought down the Shaman. Triple C jumps in. BKB's pop, turning towards Universe. Universe keeping himself alive with the Midnight Pulse and the Ultra Recoil heal. S-Triple C blinks away. Arteezy is back in the game. S-Triple C comes back. Crit brings it back in. Arteezy takes him down. S-Triple C's gone, but he did not buy back for that affair. He was already alive, so he is not on the dieback. But EG, you know, they have to commit pretty hard for this. There is definitely an opportunity to take this game if they can bring down Moogie.
Level 25 Bloodseeker.
Oh, Universe puts the BKB preemptively, tries to get the jump, he's found the black hole. It is onto KP. Do they actually have the damage to finish him off? Zai comes in with the epicenter.
He stoned him.
Oh,
he saved him. Oh my god.
He keeps KP alive. Beautiful play from Kaka. He managed to save him. There's the second of black hole, but Universe is down. They've lost two. Sonic Wave flies through from S-Triple C. Triple kill for Moogie. EG are all dead. And GG is
gone. Kaka, are you kidding me?
Kaka! What a play there. The Aghanim Zerspirit, I believe he only just picked it up.
Oh,
keeping KP alive.
My god, that was absolutely beautiful.
Wow.
And
with that, that's EG down. Knocked down to the lower bracket. Newbee with an incredibly deserved victory. 2-0.
We talked about the Blink BKB enigma so much, but that was just damn impressive how Newbee played around it. Small mistakes from EG costing them heavily, but Newbee recognized what they wanted to do in this game. They had to change the pace and make sure they were the ones causing the fights to happen, and that's what they did.
Absolutely.
Wow.